Hey guys, welcome to a pick video. Today we're going to be looking at the chicken picks from the Netherlands. But first, if you're new to the channel, please go down and subscribe. It's really going to help me out, bring in more interesting stuff and just keep on going with the channel. So yeah, these picks are, you know, they are expensive boutique picks, and I really like expensive boutique picks. They really affect my playing in a good way and my tone. So yeah, I love boutique picks, but you can argue with me about, you know, using, you know, wafer thin Dunlop picks if you want. But personally, thick picks are the way to go. Like, 1 millimeter is the minimum. I suppose there are exceptions, but anyway, these are made out of thermosetting plastic and they're really, really strong. Like, really strong. They're also really light. I don't know what it is, but they kind of feel same weight as a really thin pick. Kind of got a chalky texture to them. They're got a really fast attack on the note, on the string as well, and also sound really bright. One thing I'd also say, sounds a bit weird, but with these picks you can almost feel the string through the pick. They've got really a lot of vibration in the actual pick. That's just something that I found using these picks. So, one thing that I will say about these picks is that because they are white and kind of matte finished, is that they get dirty really easy. So if that's, you know, something that might bother you, then don't get white picks, look at something else. But if, like me, you don't really care, which I don't think you should really care, then they're great. So I've got the whole range of chicken picks here. First we have the standard size picks for them, the standard size picks. These are quite big picks. They're probably about 10% bigger than your normal Jim Dunlop style pick. Yeah, big picks, quite hard to hold on to, I found, just because of the size of them, and quite hard to be accurate. They're probably more of a strummer's pick, acoustic pick. So, they come in 2.2 millimeters and 2.6 millimeters. So yeah, the standard. Then we have my favorite, which is, they call it the shredder. I don't use it for shredding particularly, but it's my favorite out of the bunch. It's a bit closer to your normal sized Jim Dunlop, a bit smaller, maybe 5% smaller than your Jim Dunlop. And it's 3.5 millimeters thick. It's the thickest pick that they do, and yeah, I really like that. But if you don't like thick picks, it might be a bit of a jump for you to go from a normal pick to a 3.5 mil pick. Next we have the badass picks that they do. These are probably more of your jazz style picks, if you can see. Yeah, more if you're used to your Jazz 3 and Jazz XL size picks, they're kind of in between that size. They come in 2 millimeters and 2.5 millimeters. And finally, we have the Bermudas, which are like a three-corner pick thing. The bottom corner is slightly shallower or less sharp than the other two corners, which I find really useful. These are probably my second favourite out of the bunch. So you get 2.1 millimeters and 2.7 millimeters. They're all kind of weird gauges, all in the same sort of ballpark of 2 millimeters to 2.7 millimeters, apart from the shredder. You know, I'd like to see a bit more variation in different thicknesses, but there's a pick for everyone here. You know, that if you like your big picks, or your jazz style picks, or your slightly smaller picks, you're covered. As they're all made out of the same material, I'm not gonna run through what each one sounds like, that'd be a boring video. But I am gonna put up my favorite, the Shredder 3.5, up against a normal Jim Dunlop, just so you can hear the difference in attack and tone. But like I say, the differences are subtle. A lot with these expensive picks is that it's more about the feel. But with these picks, there is a definite tone difference. So, without further ado, let's hear what they sound like. Please subscribe, and thanks for watching. Cheers. We'll be right back.